How you doing? It's Mike and Orla live until 8 o'clock, and we're delighted that we have some company in studio for once. Head of News, head of 98FM News, Judy Gates is in the studio!
Yay!
Now, as to why there is a man from both the Coast Guard and Adventure Training Ireland beside you, we'll go into detail on that a little bit later. But tomorrow, don't know about you Orla, but I'm going to roll out of my warm bed probably about 10 o'clock, sort of make a coffee, have a bit of brekkie and rock into work at my leisure. Tina, what are you going to be doing tomorrow morning?
I'm going to be getting up around 4, looking at what sort of kit I've got lined up for the day. Instead of looking at jeans, I'm going to be looking at waterproof stuff bags and Wellingtons and fleeces and lots of waterproof gear, because I'm going to be heading down to Howth to get on a very, very tiny boat to go without an engine out into Dublin Bay and then sail across to Holyhead from Howth.
So you are going to sail across the Irish Sea tomorrow morning?
That's the plan.
Okay, why on earth would you ever decide to do something like this?
Well, it's the fault of the man beside me.
But, okay.
I decided I was going to fundraise this year for Chernobyl Children International.
Mm-hmm.
And Donnie here was, he was with me last year when I went and abseiled down the Wheel of Dublin. Another of those great ideas.
Yeah, that, yeah. The time, yeah.
Yeah. So anyhow, in the course of saying to him that I was going to fundraise this year and I'm heading to Mont Blanc with a team later on, and mm-hmm. I said to Donnie, I said, you're going to have to help me fundraise. I said, let's, and Donnie has a company called Adventure Training Ireland. So I said, maybe we could do something, you know, with boats or, you know, jet skis or something. I kind of had an idea of, you know, water skiing up the Liffey or something like that, you know, nice, visible uh-huh. and exciting.
Yeah.
Donnie says, would you sail across the Irish Sea on what's now known as Donica's Dare?
Donica's Dare. So, Donnie, is this something usually kind of dare people? Usually it's, I dare you to go up and chat to that girl, or I dare you to go up and chat to that guy. Not, I dare you to go sail across the Irish Sea. You're very welcome, by the way. Donnie, you're from Adventure Training Ireland and a fantastic member of the Coast Guard as well. So, tell us a little bit about yourself and as to what you're going to be up to tomorrow with Tina.
Yeah, tomorrow, as Tina said, we're up at about 4 a.m, packing our bags, heading out to Howth, kitting up our sailing boat, our small sailing boat, a 19-foot keel boat, and we'll also be packing up the support vessel.
Yeah, so amazing, I've got to say, scary sea tours.
So you've got a support vessel, I'm glad to hear that.
Owen and Peter over in Scary Sea Tours are really looking after us, and they're coming with us and they're helping us track the course, and they're just fantastic. They really come all out, and they have a really big boat with an engine, which is somewhat reassuring for me.
Which is handy to have, yeah.
And what are the logistics of it now? Because we were talking during Jesse J about sort of going to the toilet, eating. Let us know a little bit more about how that's going to pan out tomorrow.
Yeah, well, the fridge at home is full of cheese and ham and coleslaw and fruit, and there's a bag decided full of nuts and rolls, glucose sweets, lots of that sort of stuff, a lot of water. The bathroom will be fine for myself and Michael, who's Mick is my business partner.
Right, okay.
Come on with us. We'll be grand.
Because I imagine you can stand up.
Yeah, the physicality is the back of the boat.
So what does Tina do?
I've been introduced to something called a shiwi.
Okay, what's a shiwi?
Which involves plastic tubing and a certain degree of talent.
Don't worry, we won't look you. You'll be fine.
How long, Tina, do you have to go without a toilet? What's the aim? You know, the aim. What time do you want to arrive? And
well, it really depends on. And I mean, the beauty of this is it depends on the wind and it depends on the swell. I mean, we really are at the, you know, the, it's the forces of nature that we're answering to. But we're anywhere between 8 and 10, or even longer.
We're hoping about 10 hours. We clocked it at about 52 nautical miles from point to point.
Mm-hmm.
And if we make about 5 knots, that's just over 5 miles an hour, we'll be there in 10 hours. All going well, we'd love to get there in 8, but we're leaving ourselves a small window on the far side,
mm-hmm.
because we have to make the ferry home.
Oh, right, okay. So you got to catch the ferry.
I have to get in there because Stena Line has just been absolutely amazing. They're
brilliant.
Going to lift the boats out of the water and ship them back over to Ireland for us. I mean, there's a whole host of people that have just made this impossible, you know, and the amount of people that are so good, you know, and we talk about recession, and I hate that word, but
uh-huh.
you know, the amount of people that are willing to get out there and help people who are trying to do something for good. I mean, Stena Line are magnificent. Avonree has been fantastic. Paul down there in Avonree has given my two sailing lessons, my crash course in sailing. SO and 911 Foods, they've been brilliant. They're supporting us. There's so many people that are really, really being tremendous. Over there in the corner of the room is mm-hmm. a chap called Peter Sweeney from Photo Gaff.
Yeah, I'm feeling great here. I've never had the paparazzi. Sorry, there's a cameraman in the support of the studio as well. So listen, the very best of luck. It's an unbelievable task to take up.
And I believe you can track you on 98fm.com.
Absolutely, yeah. Well, Peter's been helping us with that as well. We're after getting up a page on the website. It's gone live at the moment, and we've got our little boat is bobbing around literally in a sort of real live space up on the 98fm website, and it's going to move as we move, so you'll be able to chart our course rather right across.
Excellent. And it's for an absolutely fantastic cause as well. How can people donate? How can people get involved?
I've got in my charity page, so mycharity.ie. I've got a page for Mont Blanc 25, which is directly linked into Chernobyl Children International, so everything goes to them. So go online. You can go onto the mycharity.ie site, or you can go onto 98FM, or you can Google Tina Gates Mont Blanc 25. Anything you put into Google will find me.
You'll find yourself somewhere.
Well, listen, safe journey. Thank you both so much for coming in. Donica, look after her, won't you?
Thank you very much.
She's to read some news on during the week, so we'd appreciate you bringing her back.
She's not important, is she?
She doesn't need any support to be brilliant.
Tina Gates. Didn't answer, actually.
Tina Gates, best of luck. All right, fantastic stuff. This is Alexis Jordan and Good Girl. It's Mike and Orla until 8 o'clock this evening. It's a Sunday session on 98FM. Best of luck, Tina.
Thank you.
Safe sailing.
Okay, good morning. We're just after 5:30 in the morning. We've been up since about 4:30, just getting ourselves ready. So we're here on the support boat. We've got our sailing boat beside us. Just packing up, and we hope to be out of here within the next 45 minutes on our 52-mile trip to Holyhead. So it's nice and bright. Winds seem to be nice and westerly. They're steady, but not too strong, so we're looking ideal.
Well, we've just pushed out past Howth, and behind me I can see the Bailey Lighthouse disappearing, and the Kish is up in the up. Yeah, where am I looking?
That's
just
the
over
Kish Lighthouse off your,
over the starboard side. You see, I'm learning. Yay! This is Donica McCobb here from Adventure Training Ireland, who's been one of the guys who's been teaching me how to sail. I've had two crash lessons. But both he and Mick Byrne, who's here on the other side, reckon I'm going to be a total pro by the time that we get into Holyhead today. Everybody's been absolutely fantastic. Stenalink is going to bring us back when we eventually get over there. And out in the distance, we have Skerry Sea Tours, who are our safety boat for the day, packed full of paramedics and firemen and coast guards and all sorts of, and food more importantly. So we've got wind in the sails, we're making progress, and it's absolutely brilliant to be out here. What a job to have. We're trying to raise money for Chernobyl Children International. You can donate by going to mycharity.ie and looking for Tina Gates Mont Blanc 25. You can also go and check us out on the news pages at 98FM and follow our progress there. We've got a map up and I've got a little boat and it's moving out across the Irish Sea, and you can keep track of our progress there. We're also on Facebook, Twitter, just about everywhere today, and right bang smack in the middle of the Irish Sea. We're well out of Howth now. We're averaging about 5 or 6 knots, Mick, I think.
About 5 or 6 knots, yeah, on a nice broad reach.
We've got the wind behind us, the sails are full. We jibed, or jibed?
Which
jibe. We've jibed. The lessons that I got down with Paul in Avonree are really paying off. I'm understanding an awful lot more about the things that I learned, which is great. Very different out at sea, though. You don't have a point to locate on. So I'm now looking at GPS maps and figuring out exactly where we're going. It took me a while to figure out that the red arrow wasn't exactly where we were. It's where we're going to. So things are beginning to make sense in a completely different way now, and those lessons are paying off. But it's amazing out here. We had bright sunshine up until a little while ago. We've got how strong is the wind? About four knots, a little bit more.
No, we're about 12 knots of wind. We're sailing at about 5 to 6 knots on average.
We probably have maybe about 12 knots of wind. And it
we're on a broad reach, so the wind is with us, and we couldn't get better conditions, really. We're up to 7.6 knots just there now, which is nice. So our estimated time of arrival is in about 9 hours, we're hoping.
Okay, well, that's come down the numbers a bit. We were saying 12 earlier. It was very calm when we came out of Dublin first. That's Mick there from Adventure Training Ireland, Mick Byrne. Mick's been giving me sailing lessons as well. Donny is eating again. Seems to be a trend. And the lads from Scary Sea Tours are out in the distance. They're there if we need them, but they're
tracing.
Yeah, they dip down. There's quite a swell out here. It's interesting. It looks, I suppose, as a person who's not used to the sea, it looks flat, but it's not. And one of the parameters of that is seeing the other boat disappearing occasionally behind a swell. But we got some blue sky, had sun earlier, glistening off the waves. It's really quite pleasant.
And where did you hide that? Oh,
Jesus Christ.
Oh, well done, guys.
Thanks, lads.
Give me that.
You made it.
That was brilliant. Well, we had no champagne in the fridge last night.
Brilliant.
That was all that was there.
Yeah, don't leave the crane man so you drink the plumbers. I'm just going to keep her fended off here. Let's...
You got a friend in me.